Would you please stand? It is with great pleasure that we present to you the class of 2019. please remain standing for the Star Spangled Banner performed by Tenzin Kunsel, Health Science Class of 2019. Thank you, Tenzin. Please be seated. During the ceremony, we ask that you turn off all electronic devices. It is now my pleasure to welcome the Health Science Class of 2019 and their guests. I would like to acknowledge special guests seated on the stage, Robert Stafford, past president, Stony Brook Alumni Association, John Ruth, director for Revenue Integrity, Stony Brook University Hospital, Robert Pertusi, senior associate, dean of admission, Corey Fircher, assistant college register. I would also like to welcome our many colleagues and faculty who have participated in the education of our health science students and are here with us for today's ceremony. Good evening, everyone. On behalf of honored guests, faculty, administration, staff, and distinguished graduates of the class of 2019, it is my great pleasure to welcome you to the Bachelor of Science, Health Science 18th Convocation. Class of 2019, you have long anticipated this day, some with eagerness, some with anxiety, some with complicated mix of emotions. But whatever you are feeling here today, you should be proud. You've made it. I know you are anxiously awaiting to walk or possibly dance across the stage and receive your diploma, so I promise I will be brief. Class of 2019, graduation is about endings and beginnings, a celebration of achievement and the commencement of a transition to a different chapter in your lives as productive and responsible adults. Hopefully, your experience here has strengthened your sense of purpose and inspired you to continue your quest for knowledge. Remember, this is not the end to your education, but an important step forward in your journey. Your courage, your strength, your determination are a combination of years of hard work, tons of sweat to achieve success in your courses, and from the relationships and friendships developed during this time. A phrase most often spoken by the late interim dean, Carlos Vidal, was relationships are primary, everything else is derivative. Now, before you get too emboldened with your courage, your strength, your determination, I do have one important question for you to take heed of. And that is, as you go for it, you can't go it alone. You didn't learn at Stony Brook on your own, as your faculty, friends, and mentors will attest. And you won't accomplish what you dream of doing next on your own. So keep in mind, what you dream of doing next will be difficult to accomplish without goals. And to achieve your goals, you must work hard, have discipline, and seek individuals who support and encourage you. So as I conclude, to all the family and friends with us today, and to those who could not be here in person and are thinking of the graduates as we celebrate this moment, thank you. Thank you for the encouragement you offered, and in many cases, for the sacrifices you made. Graduates, I have one request. Please, would you take a moment to acknowledge all those who supported you near and far, including your own classmates and faculty. Congratulations, class of 2019. Here's to new beginnings and achieving your goals. I would like to invite Robert Stafford to the podium. He will present the Alumni Association Dean's Choice Award.
Good evening, Dean Johnson, Dr. Zelizer, invited guests, faculty, staff, family, friends, and students of the Health Science graduating class of 2019, and may I be the first to say, fellow alumni. As Dean Johnson mentioned, my name is Robert Stafford, and I am the immediate past president of the university's Alumni Association. I am honored and privileged to present the association's $1,000 Dean's Choice Award to a very special health science student. You are a diverse major with students from all over the United States and extending to many different countries in the world. Each of you has a unique story detailing how you developed the ability to preserve, persevere, and to nurture your own resilience. Right now, we want to take a minute to highlight one student in particular, one whose life experiences best exemplify perseverance and resilience that we speak of. This student was only 11 years old when he was forced to see the world as an adult. The political discourse resulting in warring factions in his country left him to bear witness to the type of violence that no one, let alone an 11-year-old child, should ever see. As anyone might surmise, the lasting impact of violence he witnessed was quite profound. Yet, nonetheless, he did persevere. He remembers that during and following the time of war, he saw people without any means to pay for desperately needed health care. He saw them suffer the consequences of violence, which resulted in no one being either able or willing to offer medical assistance. Many people lost limbs, and many others lost their lives. In fact, an estimated 1,000 people died in his community and greater than 500,000 were displaced. Yet this young man did not relent to the wretchedness that was all around him. Moreover, and equally impactful, was the fact that his way of life ceased to exist right before his very young eyes, and still he never lost hope. Instead, in 2012, he and his family left all that they knew and arrived in the United States. He has shared with faculty that he experienced jet lag as a result of long flight from his homeland to the U.S. For any of you who has ever experienced jet lag, you know that it leaves one a bit disorientated and a little irritable. But it was at that time that he heard in the distance the sound of an ambulance on its way to help someone in need. And it was that particular moment that he realized his life's calling was to serve. His new journey began when he attended high school. He worked hard and graduated in 2015 as a valedictorian. Shortly thereafter, in 2016, he became the source of comfort for many of those who suffered with health emergencies in his capacity as a certified New York State emergency medical technician. In 2017, he became a nationally registered emergency medical technician, and he currently works as an EMT here on Long Island. Interestingly, despite how busy all of this has kept him, he still finds the time to serve as a certified New York State soccer referee. As a health science student, he honorably represented his graduating class section, volunteered for the Just for Kids soccer program, which was designed to offer children with autism the opportunity to play soccer, supervised the food drive at Stony Brook University on a weekly basis, served as a teaching assistant for the anatomy and physiology course, and he has been on the dean's list since 2015. He is currently on track to pursue a degree as a physician assistant, where I have no doubt that he will represent healthcare in the true fashion of a health science graduate. And while the list of his accomplishments and service go beyond the time I have been allotted to speak, it is my hope that no one loses sight of the reality of hope, the value of fortitude, and the promise of possibility, as our recipient so valiantly has demonstrated. I will use his words in summary to speak of the resilience, dedication, and perseverance of this health science student, who represents all health science students as the recipient of this year's Alumni Association Dean's Choice Award. He states, and I will paraphrase the following, "In my journey, I responded to the loud calls for medical help as well as the silent calls from children living with autism. The gaping hole in my heart as a result of the tragic events of the past have been made smaller with each patient that I treat and with each child that I enable to smile and with each student that I have had the opportunity to help. And so, in the memory of the friends that I have lost, I have a burning ambition to help, to serve, and to heal." And so, Dean Johnson, faculty, staff, family, friends, students of the graduating class of the Health Science 2019, please join me in recognizing and celebrating this year's recipient of the Stony Brook Alumni Association Dean's Choice Award, Mr. Osama Waqid. Would you please come to the stage?
join us, take a picture?
Please, here. This is for you.
Thank you, Mr. Stafford. I would like to invite Leo Du Bois, the Environmental Health and Occupational Safety Concentration Advisor, to the podium. He will be presenting the 2018-2019 American Society of Safety Professionals Award.
Thank you, Dean. The American Society of Safety Professionals is a global association of more than 35,000 occupational safety and health professionals. The Long Island chapter of the American Society of Safety Professionals is sponsoring a $1,000 award to an exceptional student in the School of Health Technology and Management's Health Science Majors Environmental Health and Safety Concentration of Study. There were several outstanding candidates for this award, but the committee was very impressed by the letter of recommendation that was submitted by this student's internship mentor, which stated in part that this student, quote, not only served our company well, but has also paved the way for a strong relationship between the company and Stony Brook University by acting as an exemplary ambassador for the Stony Brook Health Science Program. The ASSP Environmental Health and Safety Award is presented to Lauren Belanda.
Thank you, Professor Du Bois. I would like to invite Stephanie Patterson, Clinical Associate Professor Health Science, to the podium. She will be presenting the Edward J. O'Connell Excellence in Health Award.
Edward J. O'Connell served the Stony Brook University community for over 36 years in the Department of Environmental Health and Safety's Radiation Protective Services. During that time, he fully immersed himself in campus life, working diligently on countless administrative, educational, labor, recreational, and spiritual initiatives. Ed O'Connell was a champion for safety and cared very deeply about SBU's students, faculty, and staff. In his honor, the Edward J. O'Connell Excellence in Health Science $500 Award is granted to a full-time student in the health science major. This year, we had many worthy candidates with excellent credentials, making our final selection extremely difficult. But the committee unanimously agreed on our 2019 recipient, Mr. Nicholas Chetlatka.
Thank you, Professor Patterson. I would like to invite to the podium Rahima Bukhari to deliver the convocation speech.
Good evening, friends, family, faculty, esteemed guests, and my fellow graduates in the Bachelor's of Science, Health Science class of 2019. First and foremost, let's have a big round of applause for ourselves and our friends and family who helped us get here. Thank you. A lot comes to my mind when I look back at the first day of senior year. I was sitting in a fully occupied lecture hall surrounded by strangers, and I remember thinking, oh boy, this isn't gonna be fun. I was experiencing a range of emotions, including fear, excitement, hope, and nervousness. Why, you may ask? Well, we had received a tremendously warm welcome from the respected health science faculty during orientation. After all, they had promised to support us, help us, and encourage us, but by challenging us. We all knew at that point that this journey wasn't going to be easy. It hasn't been long since that eventful day, but it sure does feel like forever ago because of how far we have come. Isn't that right, class of 2019? One of the things that stood out to me about this program was how much we were urged to be a community by every single professor. We were divided into groups for every single class, and different groups with different people, might I add. We huffed and we puffed, and we all got to work on our projects. But it was through these groups that I met some of the most best, most honest, and hardworking people in my life. Now, would that have been possible without the subtle nudge from the faculty? To be honest, probably not. This phenomena of the program caused a chain reaction where many little groups transformed into one big tight-knit community. And eventually, we all recognized every single person in our tracks, didn't we? I was so pleasantly surprised about the sense of community that I felt, especially during the fall semester. My track made sure that everyone was on the same page. Yes, all 70 of us. It is very much possible. We had each other's backs through thick and thin, through assignments and exams. Hey, everyone, don't forget that homework due tomorrow. Hi, everyone. Here's the study sheet I made for the midterm. Hope it helps. This is how much we all supported each other. And I was in awe because everyone was trying to lift their peer up, which is very rare. Anytime I needed any kind of help or support, I found myself surrounded with peers who were always ready to lend a helping hand. Those strangers that I mentioned earlier, yeah, well, they became my friends during the course of senior year. We all needed each other and all the support in the world because the classes were tough and the assignments were especially challenging. We stayed up nights and we worked long hours, but at the end of the day, we delivered. In doing so, we tapped into our potentials and we learned things that we can now apply no matter where we go. That's the beauty of health science, because this is unlike any other major on campus. We were treated like professionals, we were held accountable for our actions, and we are expected to put our best foot forward. That's how we know that we are walking away with not just knowledge, but also the skills to apply that knowledge. We conducted presentations, research projects, learned how to make a professional packet, and in doing so, we discovered how to be young professionals. The transition from student life to the real world is never easy, because you step into the real world and you realize that you weren't trained for this. I cannot say that I feel that sense of unpreparedness. In fact, I feel confident, self-assured, and very well prepared because the skills that I have acquired are the tools that I will put to use in order to navigate through this transition. I want us to be proud of all the knowledge, skills, and connections we are walking away with because we have worked for this, we have earned this, and this did not come easy. It is because this did not come easy that I know it is valuable, and I recognize all that I'm walking away with. My dear class of 2019, as each of us move toward greater things in life, I want you to remember the values and teachings we were given here. Remember your experience. Remember the obstacles you encountered. Remember how you overcame those obstacles. Most importantly, remember to keep moving forward. Persistence is the key to success, and we are living proofs of this statement because no matter how much we were challenged, we held on tight and we got through the storm. Take away as much as you possibly can from the past 9 months. I can guarantee you that if you start looking, you will find uncountable things that you can take away from this program. But I can also guarantee you that each one of us is taking away something different. Keep learning and keep recalling this experience wherever you go in life and into the great far beyond. Lastly, on this joyous day, I would like to quote a special reference. It didn't make much sense to me all this time, but now as I stand, a graduate, I understand this message because I have earned it. We have all earned it, and we have lived it throughout senior year. So take a moment and revel with me in all our glory and pride. We are the curious, the explorers, the innovators, unbound by tradition, unlimited in our potential, propelled by a vision of a bold new future. We are passionately engaged in the issues of our time. We emerge from Stony Brook with the momentum to make a real difference. Our spirit is empowered by who we are and what we have learned. It drives us in pursuit of the big ideas that will transform our lives and impact our world. We are Stony Brook University. We reach across boundaries. We break through expectations. We go far beyond. Congratulations, class of 2019. We made it. We all made it.
Thank you, Rahima. It's my pleasure to introduce Dr. Deborah Zelza.
Thank you, Dean Johnson. Oh, here we are. Didn't it seem like a minute ago we were at orientation? It is my honor to welcome you, class of 2019, to this ceremony. Graduation's a time that we somehow simultaneously reflect on the past, think about the present, and really worry about the future. As I reflect on the past, 18 years ago, when this major was created, I never would have imagined that we would become the most popular major on campus, that we would have the highest graduation rate, about half. About half of you completed this degree in 4 years. That is an amazing accomplishment. This major is a feeder to medical graduate programs, accelerated nursing programs, and graduates of this major are sought after by employers in the healthcare industry. How did we accomplish this? The answer is simple. We made a promise to each other. The day you declared this major, we promised you a rigorous, cutting-edge curriculum delivered within learning communities, communities that embrace and celebrate diversity in all its forms. Our commitment to you was to embed the best practices for student success in your major. Yes, projects and groups, sorry. But those projects and groups fostered critical thinking, evidence-based decision-making. We had real-world discussions. Sometimes they were uncomfortable, but real-world dialogue about the challenges and inequities in the healthcare system. Peer collaboration, we developed communication skills and conflict resolution skills. And of course, the health science major has the two most amazing academic advisors on this campus, Tracy Thompson and Jennifer Jimenez. So that was our part. Your commitment to us was to take responsibility for your learning and fully engage in your classes. And I speak for the faculty and staff of this major. Health science class of 2019, you have far exceeded our expectations. This class has the distinction of having the most West Campus Leadership and Service Awards and conferred 5 out of the 6 Health Science Center Awards to people in this room. Amazing. Your faculty have shared stories with me, how you have supported one another through the ups and downs of the senior year. Many of you overcame tremendous obstacles to be here today. The loss of a loved one, managing a chronic health condition, the financial strain of having to juggle full-time work and a full-time job, the added responsibility of raising a family, and through it all, you maintained very high academic standards for yourself. So let's bring our focus now to the present, to this moment. Graduates, this arena sits about 4,000 people. The room is filled, standing room only. There are people in this room that have loved and supported you. While today is your accomplishment, you did the work. You could not have gotten here without the nurturing support and guidance from the 4,000 people in this room. So please take a moment to appreciate your loved ones and how they supported you in this journey. Now, for the final time, take a look at each other. This is the last time we'll be assembled together as a class. And I know, despite your spring semester, you're in concentrations of study, you have an affinity and maintain a deep and abiding connection to your fall semester, which we call tracks. Many of you have shared with me that it was the first time, yeah, you're getting ready for your calls, right? Just give me a second. I'll be there in a minute. Many of you have shared with me that it was the first time in your college tenure that you felt a sense of belonging. So, I'm told tracks have a special way of greeting each other. They have track calls. So for the last time, let us say our track calls, and as we do that, celebrate how much your colleagues sitting next to you now supported you through this journey. So, track one. Stand. Track one. And track 6. Yeah. As we look to the future, I'd like to focus on the words that Dean Johnson shared about our former dean, Dr. Vidal. Relationships are primary, everything else is derivative. If you will bear with me for 1 second, I want to tell you a story about a phone call I had on Wednesday. It was a woman that graduated from this major 14 years ago. And she calls every year around this time just to say thank you and to kind of keep me updated. After she graduated, she went on to nursing school. She's now program director of a very prestigious nursing program in the South, and she's up for an assistant provost position. That was the update. Then she started telling me the update of everyone else in her track. She's to this day, she keeps in touch with the relationships, the primary relationships that was made in this concentration. They opened doors for each other. She shared, one of her classmates was moving down south, environmental health. She made a phone call. He got a job interview. Doors will open for you. You are joining a family of colleagues, a family of 18 years of colleagues. Oh, I lost my spot, sorry. Thank you. So I ask one last thing from you. I'm a professor, I have to give you homework, right? Here's your homework. Please keep in touch with us. Please let us know the tremendous successes you will have in your career. And please open the doors for the health science graduates that come after you. Thank you, class of 2019.
Thank you, Dr. Zelza. Although the university degree are officially conferred at the campus commencement ceremonies held at the main ceremony earlier today, the School of Health Technology and Management takes great pride in recognizing its graduates of the Health Science Program, the class of 2019. We will ask each graduate to come to the platform and receive his or her certificate of achievement. At this time, I would like to invite Margaret Sherrill to read the names of the graduates.
Thank you. I would like to invite Dr. Deborah Zelzer to the podium to present the class.
Thank you. Before I invite the graduates to the stage, the faculty would like to form a receiving line to congratulate each and every one of you on your accomplishments. So as I call your name, will the faculty please stand as they are able? Kathleen McGoldrick. Professor Sharon Cuff. Dr. Stephen Vicken. Professor Stephanie Patterson. Professor Donna Crapanzano. Professor Robbie Kincaid. Dr. Deborah Firestone. Professor Leo DeBobies. Professor Witten. Professor Lou Mancuso. Dr. Christina Burke. Professor John Ruth. Professor Sean Keane. And seated in the VIP section is Professor John Tramposh. I'd also like to acknowledge Professor Peter Flanagan and Professor Sean Edward. Oh.
seat.
Marshals.
Gustavo Abad. Tayana Abad. Jamie Abudu Sola. Alicia Ahmed. Sundas Ahmed. Raymond Alfaro. Andrew Amoa. Aisha Anber. Parsa Ashrafi. Shaylin Attard. Matthew Avella. Masood Azizi. Christopher Backus. Fatumata Ba. Lauren Belanda. Scott Bayo. Austin Barney. Jessica Bartnick. Justin Daniel Bayonetto. Melody Bayrak. Gregory Beninati. Ingrid Paola Benitez. Olga Bershansky. Rebecca Bianco. Nicole Bafulco. Stephen Blair. Dimitri Blaze. Kiara Blandeberga. Vincent Benora. Melanie Nicole Boselli. Krista Brayton. Abbas Brema. Taylor Brandt. Rahima Bukhari. Robert Burmeister. Allison Calderon. Crystal Callahan. Jessica Camilleri. Janelle Campbell. Bianca Alexis Karras. Aaron Matthew Cato. Jessica Sen. Stephanie Cerullo. Bushra Ceylon. Jeanette Chabla. Jane Chan. Chan. Emily Chan. Xiaowen Chan. Jason Chan. Karen Chen. Kelly Chen. Kelly Chen. Lawrence Chen. Michael Chen. Ming Chen. Vivian Chen. Sarah Chang. Joshua Chester. Elizabeth Chung. Hoi Yi Chong. Priscilla Chiang. Priya Chohan. Nibras Chowdhury. Brian Chow. Casey Chu. Christopher Cologne. Ashley Rose Conry. Abigail Conway. Courtney Coop. Elizabeth Cotter. Melanie Council. Alexa Crook. Brenda Cruz Reyes. Heather Cuevo. Michael Cusmano. Nicholas Chetlatka. Michael Diadamo. Anna Daniels. Kayla Daniels. Shannon Della Sola. Kimberly Diodat. Maimuna Jalla. Ashling Deneen. Thomas Dolly. Tyler Dookie. Neo Christine Duan. Nicholas Dowse. Errol Dubanco. Charlotte Elizabeth Edwards. Dahlia Aldeeb. James Esperto. Enoch Evelyn. Andre Fabro. Fei Fang. Jacqueline A. Foz. Winnie Fei. Jenna Farr. Jenna Ferrara. Michaela Flood. Jacqueline Fong. Yasmin Fushong Brown. Brian Scott Fowler. Summer Fox. Crystal Francis. Sarah Frankis. Tiffany Fong. Cynthia Sarahi Guyton. Krista Gallo. Melanie Garces. Amber Garcia. Joshua Garcia. Juliana Nicole Garamone. Gemma Garrido. Marissa Janusa. Nathaniel George. Christy Geyer. Nimra Ghani. Panayota Giannakis. Diane Gore. Eric Gremley. Peter Grasso. Brian Guardado. Matthew Guglielmo. Sarah Habeshi. Yian Han. Danae Hall. Moesha Hamilton. Anna Shea Harriet. Michaela Hardigan. Ashley Hardy. Mariam Hussanain. Jonathan Haynes. Dakota Christopher Heaney. Catherine Hernandez. Caleb Hong. Kayla Hausmand. Emily Shu. Eva Huang. Jishan Hong. Saeed Zain Hussein. Nazmin Islam. Jade Jackson. Yunsung Jang. George Jasmines. Faritza Jean.